Hello, fellow aspiring astronomers! Have you ever heard the quote, "That's one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind"? The famous astronaut Neil Armstrong said this in 1969 when he took his first step on the moon. That quote makes me think about our lesson for today. Each step that scientists, mathematicians, and philosophers took throughout history to learn more about space led us to where we are today, and thanks to the hard work of astronomers, are leading us to where we will be going in the future. Today we are going to explore the history of astronomy and those who studied it, describe the early models of our solar system, and discuss how we have established our current knowledge of space and Earth's place in the universe. So let's buckle up, because this spaceship is ready to go! Welcome back, my fellow space explorers. Before we start talking about astronomers, let's take a minute to talk about our solar system. So what is the solar system? Well, it's the sun and other celestial bodies, or things in space, that are in its orbit and revolve around it. 8 giant planets, including the Earth, smaller dwarf planets, and millions of pieces of rocks and ice orbit our sun. Moons can also be found within the solar system. They are held in orbit around planets by gravity. So, how do we come to know all of this? Well, we have to go back to the year 384 BCE. That's over 2,400 years ago. This is when Aristotle was born. He was a Greek philosopher who thought the Earth was the center of all things. His model of space placed the moon, sun, other planets, and stars all orbiting Earth. He thought that if Earth went around the sun, then the relative positions of the stars would change as Earth moved. Aristotle thought that Earth did not move. This may seem silly now, but there were no telescopes when Aristotle lived. He and other scientists looked for parallax, or a shift, in the positions of celestial bodies when they stood at different points on Earth. But they could not see any change. This is because the stars are so far away from Earth that you can only see parallax with a telescope. Maybe you have already heard of Aristotle, but what about Aristarchus, born 74 years later? He was not a Greek philosopher. He was, however, a Greek astronomer and mathematician. He first proposed a heliocentric model of the solar system. You know, a model of the solar system with the sun in the center. But believe it or not, hardly anyone believed him. Ugh. Come on, people! Now, let's jump to the year 100 CE. On Egypt's Mediterranean coast, Ptolemy, a mathematician and geographer, studied astronomy and wrote a famous book called Almagest. This book was based on 800 years of observations of the planets. He used these observations to develop a geocentric model, or a model with Earth at the center, that was used by other astronomers for 14 centuries. Ptolemy believed that planets moved in small circles, and they all moved in bigger circles around Earth, and well, it's a lot of circles. Since astronomers followed Ptolemy's model for such a long time, we can jump ahead to the year 1508 CE. This is when Nicholas Copernicus developed his own model of a heliocentric planetary system, meaning that he believed, like Aristarchus, that the sun was the center of our solar system. However, because astronomers still had no special equipment to observe outer space, Copernicus kept Ptolemy's idea that planets moved in perfect circles. This is called the wheels-on-wheels system. Even though he didn't have it all right, the heliocentric model of Copernicus is generally seen as the first modern model of the solar system to be developed. A few years later, in 1605 CE, Johannes Kepler, a German mathematician and astronomer, carefully analyzed the recorded observations of the planets and realized that the planets did not move in a circular motion. They moved in ellipses, with the sun in the center. Okay, so now that we have two important facts straight, the planets orbit around the sun, and they move in ellipses, let's talk about a very important guy, Galileo, an Italian astronomer, physicist, and engineer who lived around the same time as Kepler. From the 17th century onward, Galileo has been seen by many as the hero of modern science. Part of why he's so important to astronomers in particular is that he improved the newly invented telescope. Using the telescope, he was the first to report observations of the mountains on our moon, the moons of Jupiter, the phases of Venus, and the rings of Saturn. He also studied gravity and some other pretty awesome science that we will cover in future lessons. All of these discoveries and more helped to finally propel us into the modern era of astronomy. Now we understand that the solar system is heliocentric, with all the planets and moons within it orbiting around the sun on elliptical paths. And although we've learned a lot since the days of Aristotle and Aristarchus over 2,000 years ago, we'd never have gotten here without the ability to build on those earliest scientific discoveries and theories. We've come to the end of our lesson for today, but if you found this topic interesting, investigate to learn more. And don't forget to check out the engaging games and thought-provoking resources related to this lesson. And always remember, in astronomy, as in life, you are out of this world! Hey!